My name is Hajra Khan. I am the captain of Pakistan National Women's Football Team. I've been playing football for about 10 years now. This one afternoon, my mom comes to me. It's summer holidays and, you know, we don't, there's no school. So she comes to me and with the newspapers and she says that provincial team ke trials ho rahe hain for Sindh. And I told her I had not played football before. So she says I'm athletic and I should actually try to, you know, make use of it. Because I used to run track and field, so I'm running, and she says, why not run after a goal? So she was my first motivation, and I went for the trials, and I got picked by a club team, which is a rank higher than the provincial team. And that's when my journey started. In 2008, I was 14 years old. 2 months being introduced to football, I was already the top scorer of Pakistan. I turned 16, and that's when I got into the got selected for the national team. And I've been on the national team ever since 2010. And I became captain when I was 20 years old. I'm 25 now, and it's been great. My immediate family has always been supportive, thankfully, my parents and my siblings. But I had some hesitance from my extended family, where my uncles and my aunts, they were not actually okay with me playing football or me traveling abroad or me playing in shorts. But my dad stood up for me. He motivated me. I mean, the result was that my extended family, they stopped speaking with my family for about 4 years, and because it was unacceptable. Lekin, thankfully, thank God, I had support from my parents. So the women's team hasn't really been supported by the Pakistan Football Federation, I would say, over the course of years. The last time the women's team played was in 2014. It was in November in Islamabad, which was the South Asian Football Federation Cup. It's very politicized. I mean, it's all power play right now. A couple of years ago, FIFA banned Pakistan Football Federation because of third-party interference. Is because you know, some parties on the government tried to intervene and take over the federation, because the Pakistan Football Federation does not come under any government authorities. It comes under FIFA, which is the international body for all football federations across the world. The Pakistan Football Federation got banned, and then, you know, the ban was lifted, and right when the ban was lifted, the men's team took a trip to like two tournaments, and like one friendly is already, and you know, the women's team has not done anything at all, the senior team. And I feel like it's very unfair, especially when the funds had been allocated. Every year there's a specific amount of budget that is given for every country's women's football and men's football development, international tournament. So it's really a lot of inequality that's been going on around, you know. It's mainly, like I said, it's just a formality for the funds to keep coming in. A lot of federations and, you know, women's teams in the region that we usually compete in, South Asia, and you know, they have been writing to me personally and asking, and have been eager for us to participate as Pakistan in the last championship. You know, they want friendly games, and they want us to participate and to play against us or with us, you know. So it's very demotivating. It's very disappointing, because, I mean, if other teams and if other regions and if other federations are looking forward for Pakistan to participate in their tournaments or in, you know, tournaments they're part of, then why do we not have the support that we need from our federation? You know, women's football across the world, it's the Women's World Cup this summer in France. And women's football around the world, the development is on fire, except Pakistan. Why? From a footballer, if you take away the right to play football or the chance to play football or to express themselves, you know, it really takes a toll on the mental, I would say, mental health of the athlete, as it has of mine. I have clinical depression, I have functional anxiety, and football used to be my sanctuary, my expression. Football used to be, you know, it was a way of life. I used to eat, sleep, breathe football. But, you know, but it's just that ever since we've stopped playing these international matches, it has really taken a toll. Teams abroad or in the region think about winning, but all we want is a chance to play. You could say becoming a football player in Pakistan is not easy. I would say that, because I've been playing for a decade now, and it hasn't been easy for me to get to this place. It's how it is for everything you want to achieve. Now, goals bade set karenge to phir, you know, you get somewhere. The higher the goals, the further you get. The adrenaline that you get from playing a contact sport and doing well at it, it keeps me going. And the sport that I've gotten now, I mean, at the point that I am in my career as a football player, it's been great, it's been immense. Now I want to be an example for the girls that are coming up. I feel like, you know, when we walk on the field and when we're standing in line right before the game and the national anthem, you know, is loud on the speakers, and you know, with my hand on my chest, it's really trembling. It's a feeling I feel like nobody can explain. I mean, every athlete in Pakistan who's representing the country knows the feeling, knows what it really feels like, knows the adrenaline and the patriotism that kind of awakens when you're on the field. It's just you just want to get out of there, and you just want to perform and represent the country and do the best you can ever do. I feel like it's a lot of love for the country. It's a lot of love for the sport, and you know, no matter, you know, I mean, it's like, because the journey is so tough, when you finally get there, it just feels the best ever, you know. I wouldn't want to be somebody else. I would just be myself, and you know, just this one, I don't know, just this one wish is the dream that I want to play the World Cup with my own team. That is.